Radio Sputnik.
A trade deal between the UK and the European Union is now on the brink of being reached after it emerged both sides have moved closer towards a compromise on fishing. Yet this move could infuriate many Leave voters who believed a post-Brexit Britain could return to the glory days of the 1970s when fishing brought in huge revenue for the UK. We spoke to journalist Marcus Stead on the subject of fishing and the ongoing Brexit negotiations between the UK and the EU.
It's absolutely extraordinary just how finely they're cutting these negotiations. Due to COVID dominating the news agenda, events taking place in Brussels aren't being given the prominence they otherwise would or indeed deserve. And the Brexit negotiations are not something that can be taken right up until midnight on New Year's Eve. It's now early November, and the entire business community needs to know where it stands so that importers and exporters can prepare to implement whatever the reality will be from the start of January. And a reminder that the end of the year is now just 9 weeks away. The entire business community can handle bad news a lot better than they can handle uncertainty. If you've received bad news in any area of your life, you can act accordingly. If there's a poor deal coming, or no deal at all, businesses can use the time to adapt and adjust for all that. Millions of us are going through a difficult enough time at the moment with the pandemic and not being able to conduct business or work in the usual way. The lingering uncertainty is doing nobody any good at all, and it's particularly disappointing that the Brexit negotiations weren't concluded by mid-October, which was the UK government's original deadline. But we are where we are. Negotiations have continued throughout the weekend. It's likely we'll have a much clearer idea as to whether there'll be a deal or not come Wednesday or Thursday of this week. And it appears there are two real sticking points that are making a deal difficult. The first is fishing. The EU wants to maintain its rights to Britain's fishing waters. Under the Common Fisheries Policy, all member states are given access to EU waters via quotas. The UK has a particularly large coastal area, 756,000 square kilometres, easily the biggest when the UK was in the EU. The next nearest is the Republic of Ireland with 410,000 square kilometres. And between 2006 and 2016, an average of 760,000 tonnes of fish were caught by EU countries in UK waters each year, compared to just 90,000 tonnes by UK fishermen in EU waters. But let's be frank about this. There's a danger that the UK could overplay its hands on fishing. Since entering what was then the EEC in 1973, the British fishing industry has been utterly decimated as a direct consequence. The figures I just quoted back that up. Fishing does feel emotionally important in terms of negotiations as a result, but in terms of fishing's economic importance, it is minuscule. In 2016, turnover for the entire UK fishing industry was £725 million. To put that into perspective, the turnover for Harrods department store alone was £2 billion. The second sticking point is the issue of state aid, and the UK government has stated its position, namely that it wants to set its own rules on the state's support given to businesses. From the EU's point of view, state aid is defined as any state spending that potentially distorts trade between member states. And the EU state rules are enforced by the European Commission, and the compromise in this area risks giving the Commission a permanent say in the United Kingdom's domestic affairs, which will outrage many Brexiteers. Cabinet Office Minister Michael Gove has made his stance on this clear by saying that when it comes to state aid, in free trade agreements, it is unusual for it to include anything beyond limited and specific provisions on subsidy policy, mainly in relation to issues of transparency. And in that regard, Mr. Gove says that the EU has already set precedents on the limits and interference in other countries' spending on state aid with the free trade agreements it already has in place with Canada and Japan. And the issue of state aid takes on a new importance as we continue to battle the COVID pandemic. In terms of the economy, one of the big advantages of a full and complete Brexit will be the flexibility for the government to target aid at specific industries that have been decimated by the pandemic. And in the months ahead, it will become clear that the sectors demanding state aid will be enormous, from entertainment to sport to the likelihood that railways will need to be renationalised, as the enormous drop in passenger numbers will result in private rail operators being unable to make a profit. So there's a lot at stake in the next few days.
You mentioned earlier that fishing doesn't economically
really pack the punch that it used to, and it seems to be more of a symbolic gesture to really fight for the fishing waters of the UK from the government. Do you think this is a key area where Boris Johnson and his Brexit negotiators could compromise, or would that do too much damage to the general public's perception of Brexit?
Well, as I just outlined, in terms of the fishing industry's economic importance, it really is minuscule with the figures I just gave you a moment ago. But it's very much an emotional thing. The British fishing industry was far bigger in 1973 than it is today. So to be seen to be backing down on fishing would be to feel it would feel like a betrayal in the fishing communities of Britain, both on the South Coast and in the Yorkshire area and so forth, and Humberside and everywhere like that. But in terms of economic importance, I'm afraid the British fishing industry has been decimated since 1973, but the government cannot be seen to be backing down on this because of the emotional attachment many Brexiteers in those areas have to fishing, and it would be seen as a sellout if a compromise was reached. That's the emotional reality, but in terms of economics, I'm afraid the fishing industry is minuscule in Britain now.
Radio Sputnik.